Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. And now we are going to be starting a series of lectures regarding PHP, and I'm going to start with basics, and then we are going to learn advanced concepts of PHP. So you have to stay tuned. In each and every video I'm going to be explaining different concepts of PHP, and to get notifications of whenever I upload a video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell. So let's get started.
First, create variable name must start with a letter or an alphabet, but in our case it should always start with dollar sign, then anything can come after that. Variable names can have A to Z, capital A to Z, 0 to 9, underscores, no space should be given in a variable name, and this is case sensitive. So if you write ABC in small and ABC in capital, both are not same, they are different. And then you have string variables, you give it like this in double quotes. Then here you see, okay, there is another interesting thing, username, variable username, which is initialized with the value Fred Smith. Echo username, this will print this name, Fred Smith. Then echo br, if you people remember from HTML, br is used to give break. So if you want to use any HTML tag, whether it is heading tag, paragraph tag, break tag, you can give inside the echo command in double quotes. Current underscore user is equal to username, same as Fred Smith, echo current user. So in two lines it will display first Fred Smith, and in the next line again Fred Smith would be the output. These are the numeric variables. If you initialize a variable with a numeric value, it becomes a numeric variables. Again, this is a floating point number, but definitely it's numeric. And then we have array. Again, it's very simple to create an array. We have given the dollar sign, it means we want to create a variable. But here we use the array, array keyword to create an array. So we are creating array. How we know? Through this array keyword. First element is Bill, Mary, then Mike, Chris, Anne. So this is an example that this keyword array is used for creating an array. And when we echo team 3, what will be printed? Team 0 is at 0 location we have Bill, 1 Mary, 2 Mike, and at index 3 we have Chris. So Chris would be printed. See, it displays the name Chris. Okay, that's how you will access the elements of array. Then we have multidimensional array. As I told you that multidimensional array or a two-dimensional array consists of rows and columns. It has two dimensions. So that's how you can declare a multidimensional array inside an array. We have created an array and we have given it multi dimensions, 1, 2, and 3 dimensions. Okay, so if we want to access it, OXO12. Now what it will do? OXO1 means this one, second array, and then what it is? 2, this one, 0, 1, 2. So it will display X. You can already see the output, see, which will display an X. Why? Because first it will select the row, first row. So it starts with 0, so this is the 0th row. And this is the first row. Then 2 means column. So the second column, the second row and third column, X.